Okay, so we're here on day 11, today's day 11, February 11th. We arrived in Balboa yesterday. And this morning, we're on our way to Trenton at the Quint West City Hall to meet Mayor Williams. And yesterday, we had a great day meeting Mayor Ellis. And part of the story when we arrived there was, we were talking about Mr. Paul Armstrong, who's to my left here. Because me and Paul go way back, and you know, we decided to do this little story here just to kind of reflect back over the years, because there's been many times when we came to your hotel over the years, and you've been very instrumental in helping us secure other accommodations during our campaigns as well. Maybe Paul, if you just wanted to kind of touch back on the first time we met, and then throughout the years, how many campaigns that you remember seeing me?
Oh, a lot. Every year. I can't imagine the miles that you put on your feet going back and forth across the province and in different areas of the country. We as a company have always been very receptive to good causes, and among those causes, yours is certainly one of the best. The effort that you put behind it, the objectives you have, and the good that you've done overall has been just amazing. And for us to be a part of that has been our honor, more so than anything else. It's been absolutely wonderful. Yes, we certainly try to help you every step of the way, and we certainly appreciate the fact that you acknowledge that.
Well, I always do, and I'm trying to remember the first time that, I don't know, in 1999, when we did the Ontario walk, if that was the first time that, because I came through Balboa during that time, and I think that might have been the first time. It's hard, because it's a long time ago.
Yeah, it's a long time ago.
I'm getting older.
I know.
My brain isn't much good.
I believe it would have been 2000.
It was the Canada walk then?
That's right. It was the Canada walk, because I came to Balboa in that year. So in 99, I was up in Timmins, Ontario.
Right.
As of 2000, I was in Balboa. So that was the first encounter.
Well, it's been wonderful for us. And you know, when they're offering us congratulations for what we're doing, I can't say that this was done. I have to always mention, it's always been people like yourself that always make these things possible. So if they're saying that we're responsible for helping to save lives, then that makes you responsible for helping to save lives.
That's a good feeling.
It is. It's a very good feeling. So with that, Paul, thank you so much.
Thank you, George.
Until our next adventure, I guess.
Okay.
Take care.
Parliament Hill on the first of this month, and plans to arrive at Queen's Park next Friday. Okay, and generally, the program is called like Step by Step, and it's to bring awareness to sickle cell, all right, and organ and tissue treatment, stuff like that, okay? And he wants Walking Wounded by Tea Party coming up, and George, you're doing a fine thing out there walking along Highway 2. And expects to arrive in Quinte West at the City Hall there about 3 o'clock this afternoon. So I know yesterday he was at Belleville's City Hall with Mayor Neil Ellis. So George Marcello, if you see him walking along the road, say hello, throw some money at him too, all right? And bring awareness, of this bill dealing with the sickle cell illness. And so we wish him all the best. George, we got Walking Wounded for you. Tea Party coming up.
Is it safe to look within and erase all that's been and all that's been between? Is it
behind you. Perfect. Excellent.
Well done. This is.
Now, I just want to let you know at this part of the event, I try and persuade the deputy mayor to encourage both the MPP and the MP to support this, what we're trying to do. Because mm-hmm. There's a bill tabled about a month ago at Parliament Hill. It's Bill C. 605 mm-hmm. By MP Kirsty Duncan, and basically the bill entails to recognize sickle cell disease as a legitimate disease mm-hmm. and bring comprehensive care. And so basically in her bill it says that there will be a total evaluation of the situation where the care is needed mm-hmm. And then hopefully implement it afterwards. Okay. So just simple things like bracelets, which presently don't exist because mm-hmm. it's not recognized as a disease in Canada, mm-hmm. Will become available. So people suffering with that disease, if they're because they go through different intensive period in mm-hmm. their illnesses, they might be in sometimes a semi-coma, mm-hmm. and nobody knows what's wrong with them because yeah. there's no bracelets,
yeah.
you know.
Great idea.
So yeah, that's one of the things that, but if we can, you know, just get enough MPs mm-hmm. to support the bill, then hopefully we can get a speedy passage for
it. We can definitely speak to the MP here, Rick Norlock, and also to our MPP, Lou Rinaldi.
Oh, good. Good.
Who's had some connection as a parliamentary assistant for different ministers in the provincial government. Of course, health being a provincial responsibility. It's kind of important that they pick that up in Ontario.
Perfect.
Yeah.
And I have something else to add.
Yes.
During our way to Smith Falls, Mayor Dennis Staples was there to greet us. Mm-hmm. And he also made an announcement that during the Roma conference.
Yes, coming up at the end of the month.
Coming up at the end of the month. He's using his card or his, you know, to bring sickle cell as an issue. And also he's going to further that by sitting down with Deborah Matthews,
the Minister of Health,
to try and encourage her. So while he's at the conference, and then there's a future conference after that in London.
Yes.
Yeah, he's going to try and encourage all the municipalities to become aware of it. So,
well, you know, that's a really great idea. They have a municipal organization that puts on the conference called AMO, Association of Municipalities of Ontario. And I work with it, one part of that around the environment, around waste diversion. And I can mention to the policy analyst there, who's fairly significant in the organization, that this is something that should be brought to the table from their end as well. And they would then speak on behalf of all the municipalities in Ontario. So they could put it out as an information item to start with, and at the conference, if there's a rallying of support, then it'll come back from all the municipalities to the minister, so that this is an issue that needs to be looked at more seriously.
Sounds like another step forward.
Moving in the right
direction.
Yeah,
that's perfect.
Yeah.
And Ontario does hold probably most of the people that are suffering with mm-hmm. this disease, you know, but there is some in BC and more in Quebec and Nova Scotia as well. Mm-hmm. But Ontario has the most of the population. And what else? I think
tissue donation.
Okay, what's the connection?
Yeah.
Okay, so we've been promoting organ and tissue donation step right. by step for 14 years.
Yeah.
And we've been recruited by other groups to lend the torch in our charity to help put them on the map as well. Mm-hmm. And hepatitis C, for example, mm-hmm. When that blood tape was going on, because that led to liver transplants for
right.
some of the people that got tainted by the blood.
Mm-hmm.
Diabetes. We did a whole campaign with the because there was no machines to accommodate, because there was a growing number of diabetics,
right.
and there was no machines to accommodate them. So we did a campaign, because that led to kidney transplants. Now, with the case with sickle cell disease, it's bone marrow transplant.
Mm-hmm.
And this is actually recent stuff that now bone marrow has is a successful avenue to cure sickle cell.
Wow.
People with sickle cell.
That
and
awesome.
And yeah, we've had some amazing work done by the doctors around the world. One in Toronto, SickKids, Dr. Gassis.
Mm-hmm.
And so the word's got to get more out there now to encourage more people to be registered on what we call the World Bone Marrow Registry.
Mm-hmm.
And along with people suffering with leukemia that, mm-hmm. you know, and other blood disorders that are there for people that could have their life saved through a bone marrow transplant, sickle cell should be included.
Mm-hmm.
And so we have to still make some steps. In, because if you look at most of the medical literature in different countries, they're not including sickle cell yet as a disease that can get cured by bone marrow.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the other awareness mm-hmm. that we're bringing is to you know, let all the countries know that you know, sickle cell should be included.
Mm-hmm.
And so that now that people that are suffering with that disease, their physicians can check the registry if there's any matches.
And look for that, yeah. What do you know what the prevalence is in, say, Ontario in terms of the number of people that are likely affected by sickle cell?
Well, it's a good question. Because there's been lack of research dollars,
mm-hmm.
They have never been able to really get an exact number because mm-hmm. they don't have the budget to find out.
And identifying it and at least having it classified would allow people to be able to get some quantifying behind it.
Exactly, because if that's one of the things that comprehensive care would bring,
right.
is that, you know, there would be more stations set up and we'd be able to get a more exact number of people affected.
Because mm-hmm.
People could get registered when they have it. Because right now, when you become adult, if you're an adult suffering with this, you're not going to be you're not going to be a known sickle cell person. Only if you're a child, because they register you at SickKids. So as far as the number, that's a very good question. Because
mm-hmm.
First of all, you know, the symptoms sometimes aren't even made aware to the person that's afflicted with it because there's not enough awareness out there, because there's not enough clinics and for people. So even that person that doesn't even know they have it isn't registered.
So they need to have some identification and obviously some blood tests and some workup to be able to...
Exactly. That's where comprehensive care comes in. 'Cause